हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर यू विल बी स्टडी टुवर्ड्स थॉमसन्स एटॉमिक मॉडल एंड रदरफोर्ड्स न्यूक्लियर एटॉमिक मॉडल. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल थॉमसन्स एटॉमिक मॉडल. आफ्टर द डिस्कवरी ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड प्रोटॉन, साइंटिस्ट एज्यूम दैट ओनली टू काइंड ऑफ पार्टिकल, दैट इज इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड प्रोटॉन, आर प्रेजेंट इन एन एटम. आफ्टर दैट क्वेश्चन अरोज दैट towards the position of electron and electrons and protons in an atom. Position means the distribution of electron and proton in an atom. The answer was given by J.J. Thomson in the form of first model of atom. He proposed that positive charge is spread over the sphere in which electron are embedded to make the atom as a whole neutral. This model was much like resins in pudding and is also known as Thomson's plum pudding model. So in other word, we can say that according to Thomson's atomic model, an atom is like the watermelon, spherical in nature. Inside it, the cloud of proton compared with the fleshy part and the seed compared with the electron. Means in the cloud of proton, the electron are found to be embedded. It look as the resin in pudding, therefore this model is also called as Thomson's plum pudding model. This model was discarded as it was not consistent with the result of further investigation, such as scattering of alpha particles by thin metal foil. Now, next is Rutherford's nuclear atomic model, including alpha particle scattering experiment. So, first of all, Rutherford's scattering experiment, that is Rutherford's alpha particle scattering experiment, that is discovery of nucleus. In 1911, Ernest Rutherford and his co-workers carried out a series of experiment using alpha particle. The alpha particle produced from polonium, atomic mass 214. To the discovery of nucleus, Rutherford did alpha particle scattering experiment by bombardment of alpha particles on thin metal foil like gold foil. So far that he took fluorescent tube. This is the fluorescent tube made by zinc sulfide. Inside the fluorescent tube, he took the thin foil of metal like gold foil, and on that he also took the aperture in the fluorescent tube so that alpha particle can enter inside it, because the metal foil was inside the fluorescent tube. So from this aperture, alpha particle just strike to the metallic surface. In this striking of alpha particle, maximum alpha particle penetrated the gold foil without deflection in their path and made glow, that is light, on fluorescent tube. Few alpha particle penetrated the gold foil but making somewhat angle from its path. But very few particle made the angle more than 90 degree, or we can say that it came back in same direction with the same angle, that is 180 angle. So a beam of alpha particle was directed against the thin foil of about 0.0004. We can say this one as 4 into 10 to the power minus 4 centimeter, or 4 into 10 power minus 7 meter thickness of gold, platinum, silver or copper respectively. This foil was surrounded by circular fluorescent zinc sulfide screen. Whenever alpha particle struck the screen, it produced a flash of light. Means when the particle, alpha particle is strike on the surface of fluorescent tube, it gave glow, that is gave the flash of light. These are the observation which made by this experiment means alpha particle experiment. First one is most of the alpha particles, nearly 99% were state about suffering any, without suffering any deflection, as I already described. A few of them got deflected through small angle. A very few particle means about 1 in 20,000 did not pass through the foil at all, but suffered large deflection more than 90 degree, or even came back in more or less the direction from which they had come, that is a deflection of 180 degree. So this is the figure. In that maximum alpha particle penetrated the gold foil without deflection. A few particle deflected but penetrated the gold foil, but very few particle made the angle more than 90 degree, or we can say that some very few particle come back in the same direction by making the angle about 180 degree. So here the conclusion of this alpha particle scattering experiment: since maximum, that is approximately 99 maximum particle penetrated, including the penetration of gold foil without making any angle, means without deflection, or by making somewhat penetration of gold foil by making the somewhat angle, which indicate the maximum part, that is the space of an atom, is vacant, that is hollow. A very few particle came back in same direction by making the angle 180 or more than 90 degree, which indicate the very few volume of an atom is concentrated with hard particles. Means since most of the alpha particle went straight through the metal foil undeflected, means without deviation in their path, it means that there must be a very large empty space within the atom, or the atom is extraordinarily hollow. A few of alpha particles were deflected from their original path through moderate angle. It was concluded that whole of the positive charge is concentrated and the space occupied by this positive charge is very small in the atom. When alpha particles come closer to this point, they suffer a force of repulsion and that deviate from their path. The positively charged heavy mass, which occupy only a small volume in an atom, is called as nucleus. Means the very, very less volume of an atom is composed by positive charge heavy mass, which was called as nucleus, which was in the center of the atom. It is supposed to be present at the center of the atom. A very few of the alpha particles suffered from deflections or even return on their path, indicating that the nucleus is rigid, that is very hard, and alpha particle recoil due to direct collision with the heavy positive charge mass. Rutherford's model: on the basis of alpha particle scattering experiment, Rutherford proposed a model of the atom which is called as nuclear atomic model. According to Rutherford's nuclear atomic model, an atom consists of a heavy positive charged nucleus where whole of mass of the atom is concentrated. The magnitude of positive charge on the nucleus is different for different atom. Means the different atom contain the magnitude of positive charge in the nucleus differently. The volume of the nucleus is very small and only माइन्यूट फ्रैक्शन ऑफ द टोटल वॉल्यूम ऑफ द एटम. न्यूक्लियस हैज डायमीटर ऑफ द ऑर्डर ऑफ 10^-12 टू 10^-13 सेंटीमीटर एंड एटम हैज अ डायमीटर ऑफ द ऑर्डर ऑफ 10^-8 सेंटीमीटर. देयरफॉर हियर वी कैन कंपेयर द साइज ऑफ न्यूक्लियस विद द साइज ऑफ कंप्लीट एटम. सो हियर साइज दैट इज डायमीटर ऑफ एटम अपॉन डायमीटर ऑफ न्यूक्लियस. सो द डायमीटर ऑफ द एटम इज 10^-8 सेंटीमीटर एंड द डायमीटर ऑफ न्यूक्लियस इज 10^-13 सेंटीमीटर. सो ऑन सॉल्विंग वी गेटिंग 10^5 which indicating the size of atom is 1,00,000 time more as compared to the size of nucleus. That is, the diameter of the atom is 1,00,000 times the diameter of the nucleus. There is an empty space around the nucleus called extranuclear part. In this part, electrons are found to be present. The number of electrons in an atom is always equal to the number of proton. Means an atom is electrically neutral. Means the number of the charge present on electron is found to be equal to the charge present on proton, but the sign are found to be opposite. Due to that, they cancel to each other. As the nucleus part of the atom is responsible for the mass of the atom, because the mass of proton present in the nucleus are found very, very high as compared to the mass of electron. Means we can say that the mass of an atom is approximately depend on the mass of nucleus, that is the mass of proton. The extranuclear part is responsible for its volume. The volume of the atom is about 10^15 times the volume of nucleus. So here, if we compare the volume of whole atom with the volume of nucleus, then we getting the volume of atom is found to be 10^15 times more as compared to the volume of the nucleus. So how to know? This can we compare by taking the volume of atom which divide by the volume of nucleus. Since here the diameter, that is the size of atom, is 10^-8 centimeter, and the volume and the size, that is diameter of nucleus, 10^-13 centimeter. So taking its volume, we have to take the cube. So volume of the atom is equal to 10^-8 to the power whole 3 upon the volume of nucleus, that is 10^-13 to the whole 3 is equal to 10^-14 upon 10^-39. So on solving, we getting this one 10^15. Means the volume of atom is 10^15 times more as compared to the volume of nucleus. Electron revolve around the nucleus. Revolve means the rotation, circular motion as well as axial motion. If the particular particle move around the particular point, then it is called a rotation. But if that particle rotate around its own axis, means around self it, means around it also, then this motion is called as axial motion, and motion around the particular point is called a rotation. So both point taking together we called as revolution. So here electron revolve around nucleus in close orbit. Suppose this is nucleus and there are different circular path around the nucleus. These are called as orbit. The centrifugal force acting on the revolving electron is being counterbalanced by the force of attraction between electron and nucleus. So here suppose this is nucleus and these are the cells, that is orbit. Suppose there is electron. So one force is take place from nucleus to the electron, that is nucleus to the circumference, that is called as centrifugal force. And since electron and proton are found to be charged, therefore force of attraction take place from electron towards the nucleus. So these forces are found to be counterbalanced to each other and electron revolve around the nucleus. This model, that is Rutherford's nuclear atomic model, was similar to the solar system. The nucleus represents the sun and revolving electron as planet. The electron are therefore generally referred to as planetary electron. So here the electron are therefore generally referred to as planetary electrons. Now the dissimilarities between nuclear atomic model and solar system. The sun and the planet are very big bodies and uncharged, while the nucleus and electron are very small objects and charged. So this is the first difference. Second difference between nuclear atomic model and solar system is the revolution of the planets in the solar system is governed by gravitational force, while the revolution of electrons around the nucleus is governed by electrostatic force. So here revolution of, in other word we can say that the movement of planet around the sun is found to be governed, means controlled by the gravitational force, whereas the revolution of electron around the nucleus is governed by electrostatic force of attraction, means electrostatic force. In the solar system, there is only one planet in one orbit which revolves in any particular orbit. But in the case of an atom, the nuclear atom, in the case of nuclear atomic model of the nuclear atomic model, more than one electron may rotate in any particular orbit. So in other words, we can say that in the case of solar system, around the sun in the particular path, but only one in the particular path, only one planet is found to be revolve. But in the case of nucleus, nuclear atomic model, means around the nucleus in the particular path, more than one electron can revolve. Now the drawback of Rutherford's nuclear atomic model. So first drawback, so main drawback of the Rutherford nuclear model is that Rutherford was unable to give the stability of an atom. So here, first one, according to classical electromagnetic theory, when a charged particle move under the influence of an attractive force, it loses energy continuously in the form of electromagnetic radiation. Therefore, when the electron moves in an attractive field here created by proton present in the nucleus, it must emit radiation. As a result of this, the electron should lose energy at every turn and move closer and closer to the nucleus, following in a spiral path. The ultimate result means finally ultimate result will be that it will fall into the nucleus, thereby making the atom unstable. Bohr made calculation and pointed out that an atom would collapse in 10 to the power minus 8 seconds. Since the atom is quite stable, it means the electron do not fall into the nucleus. Thereby, this model does not explain the stability of atom. Therefore, Thereby, this model does not explain the stability of the atom. So remember this point. If the electron lose energy continuously, the observed spectrum should be continuous, but the actual observed spectrum consists of well-defined lines of definite frequencies. Hence, the loss of energy by the electron is not continuous in an atom. Thank you, students.